Now, we may not think about it all too much, but for those of us living in Tāmaki Makaurau, we're probably quite aware our city's located in the middle of a volcanic field. So what will happen if and when the city faces another eruption? New research from the Journal of Volcanology and Geothermal Research has given us a fresh glimpse into just what that might look like. And to help us unpack it all, we're so thrilled to be joined by University of Waikato Senior Lecturer Adrian Pittari, beaming in from Kirikiriroa, Hamilton. Morena, Adrian. Thank you so much for your time this morning. We really appreciate it.
Morning, Jenny.
Okay, so my first question has two parts to it. So first of all, what does the research tell us about the real possibility of a volcanic eruption?
Well, the research, what we know about the possibility of an eruption is it's quite real. The last eruption was about 500 years ago, Rangitoto Island. That's quite recent in geological time, and eruptions have generally been anywhere from every 100 years to every 1,000, 13,000 years. The problem is the pattern is erratic, so it's really hard to predict.
Yeah, so we don't actually know when the next one would be, but what would happen if we did have an eruption here in Tāmaki Makaurau?
The first issue is if a magma rises close to the surface, one of the first things that probably will happen is it will hit either water in the ground or water in the ocean, and that will cause quite a large explosion, and we could get an effect called a base surge, and you might have seen some of those on video images. Which would probably be the first hit. And later it will change to more of a lava flow or a mildly explosive eruption.
So what does that mean for people living in Auckland?
Assuming we have enough warning time, there could be...
Because that's a big part of the research, isn't it? Is the warning time.
That's right. So the key thing is detection of the eruptions early enough. These magmas... They do form in the Earth's mantle, so probably 70 to 90 kilometres below the Earth's surface. But they take time to rise to the surface. We may not detect these magmas until they probably hit the crust when they can start to cause earthquakes. And that's the point at which, if we can improve our detection systems, we can try and understand the time that it takes, which could be anywhere from a few days, maybe some weeks, if we're lucky.
Yeah. Well, as you said at the beginning of this interview, we don't know when the next eruption is going to be. But what this research is really important for is how we actually prepare for the inevitability of an eruption.
Exactly. So this research, the key aspect of the research provides a guide for the times needed to evacuate certain parts of the city. And we've seen some statistics there ranging from 37 to 55 hours, depending on different variables. But also the paper does go into quite a lot of detail about what we need to know about evacuation, the complexities of dealing with unrest, and it basically highlights a lot of issues that we need to know about.
Gosh. And it's an important conversation for us to be having. Adrian, thank you so much for your time this morning. As always with our interviews, I wish we had a bit more time to unpick more about this research, but it's the beginning of the conversation, and I appreciate your time this morning. Adrian Pittari, Waikato University Senior Lecturer, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.